So in the previous videos, we talked about transfer learning and self-supervised learning. Now let's talk about the different types of self-supervised learning. So the key idea behind self-supervised learning is that it helps us to leverage large unlabeled data sets to pre-train neural networks. So there are two main categories of self-supervised learning. One is self-prediction and the other is contrastive learning. Let's talk about self-prediction first. So in self-prediction, we design a task where we predict masked features. So you can think of these masked features as augmented, obscured, or perturbed features. So suppose you have an input training example, you can then apply a perturbation mask and obtain this perturbed example. The self-supervised task here now is to predict the original training example from this perturbed example. So the model only sees the perturbed example and now has to predict the original training example. So it's called self-supervised learning or self-prediction because we can create the labels ourselves. So here the prediction target is created from the feature. Or more precisely, here in this particular case, the feature is the prediction target. However, note that this is still a supervised prediction task. So the model gets the perturbed features as input, and it has to predict the original features, which are now the target. Now in practice, there are many different types of self-prediction tasks. Here I'm outlining a common one, which is a masked autoencoder. So for instance, think of the model as a specific type of convolutional neural network. And the input here is this masked input image that we generate from the original input image. And the model now has to predict the original input image from this masked image. So by doing that, the model learns the structure of the image. It learns to understand the content of the image so that it can fill in the missing blanks here. And then yeah, after pre-training a model using the self-prediction task, we can then transfer it to the new target task, which would be, for example, an image classification task, which is analogous to transfer learning. Let's now talk about the second category of self-supervised learning, contrastive learning. In contrastive learning, we learn the relationship between similar and dissimilar inputs. Let's see what that means and how that works. So suppose we have two input images, here this bike and the tiger. So in this case, these input images are dissimilar, they are different, very different. So in this case, we want to maximize the distance between the representations of these two images. On the other hand, if we have an augmented version of this tiger here, where I changed the brightness and cropped it slightly, these two tiger images are very similar, and in this case, we want to minimize the distance. So the key idea here is that we want to maximize the distance between two dissimilar images, and we want to minimize the distance between two similar images. Now, what is this distance that we talk about and how do we measure it? So suppose we have this model here and we have this input training example. So the input training example goes into this model and the model then produces this so-called embedding vector. So you can think of the embedding vector as the output of the last layer. So if we don't have a classification output layer, if we have, let's say, a larger fully connected layer, this fully connected layer would produce our embedding vector. Now, if I take a perturbed version of this input image, where I change, for example, the brightness slightly and crop the image slightly, it will produce a different embedding vector. And note here that we are talking about the exactly same model. So the weights between those two paths are the same. We are just applying the model to two different types of input image. And the task here of the neural network is to learn to produce embedding vectors such that similar images have a small distance and dissimilar images have a large distance. So there are many different variants of contrastive learning out there. In this video, we outlined the brief concept of contrastive learning. And in the next video, we will dive in and take a look at a classic example of contrastive learning, namely SimCLR.